Okay, so what we're going to do today is we are going to create a stencil out of words in Canva. And for the purposes of today's tutorial, I'm going to be using Canva Pro. But I do have a tutorial for the free version that works as well to create stencils. So let's get started with showing you how to create a stencil with Canva Pro. So I'm going to come up here to create design, and I'm going to select a Facebook cover. And I am going to come in here, and I'm going to place an element in here, because what I want to do is I want to I don't want to fill up the entire space. I just want to create a small area, a smaller area than the actual. Technical glitches there. A smaller area, so I don't want to fill up the entire area like this. And throughout the whole, I want to create a smaller area like that, like so. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to bring in my text. So I'm going to select a heading here. Not obviously, I'm not going to use this, but I'm just going to type in here, "Oh, what a happy day." Just going to make that white so we can see it. Okay, and I'm just going to come in here. I'm going to change the font to something larger, maybe to that, and I'm going to make it a lot bigger. Going to also justify it to the left, which is my other right. And so here you have it. Oh, what a happy day. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we are going to download this as a PNG, but we're not going to make it transparent. So we're going to come in here. I'm going to press the download. I'm going to keep it as a PNG, but I'm not going to select any of these. I'm just going to download this. Okay. So I'm going to create another page here just to show you the difference. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to upload that back into Canva because I've downloaded it now as an image in PNG format. And so now all the elements are kind of combined together into one image. So I'm going to go to uploads, and I'm going to grab what I downloaded, which is right here. I'm going to open that up. I'm going to add it to my page, and I'm now going to remove the background of this photo. So I've got it selected. I'm just going to come here to edit photo. I'm going to select the BG remover, background remover. Now, if you don't see this, if you, of course, again, you have to have Canva Pro. And so if you don't see BG remover, come down to apps and you'll find it either in here or in here. And you can also come in here and search for for the app. Okay, so again, we've got that selected. I'm gonna click Edit Photo, and I'm gonna click on BG Remover, which is Background Remover. All right, so here I've got my stencil. I'm just gonna click anywhere because I'm done. I'm just gonna go back, and so I've got my stencil here pretty much. You know that it's worked because when you click here, you can see the difference is that you see in here, there's no background. If you were to leave the letters the way they were with the A background, actually over here you can see it didn't totally take out the background. So what you can do is you can just decrease the brush size and come in here and just try to very carefully take out the background, and here again. Now, of course, you can make this, you can zoom in here. Of course, I can't because I'm not sure what's happening with my mouse here, but in any case, I'll just try and there. So it does work. It's just it was not working this one time, but it does work. Okay, so I'm gonna go back here, and I'm going to bring in a photo of something nice. For example, how about this? So I'm just going to set that as my background, and here is my stencil, and I can just position that however I like. And there you have it. There's that's how we've created a stencil. So if you're interested in how to do this with the free version of Canva, just click my other video, and I'll show you how to do it with the free version. Now I want you to keep something in mind. When you're selecting a font, what you don't want to do is select a font like this, because what will happen is when you go to try and remove the background, it's because the letters aren't smooth, it won't be able to totally remove the background from the letter. You need to choose a font that is smooth to make it easier. So that's why over here we had a little bit of a problem with the background remover. It's because we didn't select a font that was smooth. But you know, if I change that font to something that's smoother, for example, bright. Okay, so I'm gonna go and download that again. Come up here. I'm going to upload it back into the system. region here so that I can bring that in here. And let's take that out. I'm going to select here. I'm going to select edit photo. I'm going to select remove background. And if I come in here now, you'll see that it's all pretty evenly removed the background. So I'm just going to step back. I'm going to go back to my photo. I'm going to set it as my background. And there you have it. Okay. There it is. This is a lot better than the previous one where it was, you know, raggedy on the sides, and it didn't remove the background from the letter where the edges were raggedy. So I hope you learned something from this tutorial. If you enjoyed watching and learning, give me a thumbs up. I'd love to get your support. And subscribe for new content coming out. Bye-bye.